हाय गाइस, टुडे वी हैव विद अस अक्षित रस्तोगी, नॉट अक्षय, अक्षित रस्तोगी. तो आई सॉरी अक्षित, हैव मैनेज अ फ्यू आईएम कॉल्स बीइंग फ्रॉम द ओपन कैटेगरी एंड 96% राइट.
यस सर।
96% पे कितना आईएम द टोटल? 12,
सर यू कैन से दैट अगर
13
सारी
मेन
कॉल्स
नाम्स
को
को
कंपेयर
छोड़ के.
करें।
हाँ, मेन नाम्स को छोड़
हाँ,
के बाकी
मेन
सब
एम को छोड़ के लगभग सभी है।
ठीक है. सो वी आर गोइंग टू बस सम मिथ्स के नए 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 इंजीनियर्स को 99 के नीचे आम की कॉल ही नहीं आ सकती, ये है वो है. एंड एज वी गो अलोंग वी आल्सो टॉक अबाउट कि आईएम्स वर्सेस आईएमटी गाजियाबाद, सो व्हिच वन टू चूज एंड ऑल. सो बिफोर वी गो इनटू दैट, कैन आई नो अबाउट योर बैकग्राउंड, वेयर यू फ्रॉम?
Yeah, so I am from the western part of Uttar Pradesh. There is a place by the name of Muradabad. I am sure you must have heard of it. It is considered as the brass industry of the UP. So I have done my engineering from there only. College by the name of MIT Muradabad. It is not a very well-known college, but I have learned a lot there. And since then, I was working with a EdTech corporate. I loved my time there, and after that, I moved on towards that. And fortunately, I am here now.
Superb, superb, superb. And when you started your prep?
Sir, I left my job in the month of February 2020. After that, I enjoyed a period of month or so because I was very well occupied with the job. I was a sales manager in an EdTech company. After that, I started with some few basics, and later on, I went on towards the full-fledged preparation. And I guess till the CAT day, till the D-day, I was giving mocks and I was giving preparation, and everything went on.
Okay, so do you remember your exact first mock score? Approximate how much you were scoring in the first mock, early mock, approximate number?
Sir, I remember everything, but it is a very shameful score. I just want to say that.
Nee, I want to, because people get carried away, people get sad. पहले दो तीन मॉक में स्कोर कम आता है, then they just lose hope from the CAT exam. So I always ask this question because I want to break that myth के नहीं, पहले 5 मॉक पे स्कोर नहीं आया तो मतलब CAT हो ही नहीं पाएगा तुमसे, this and that. So that's why
Correct.
I ask this question.
So there is one more myth, which is completely with the relation of engineers. So we engineers are considered weak in verbal, but very strong in with quants. So when I first gave my mock, it was a sectional mock, I remember, and I scored somewhere around 38 percentile in verbal. I was like, okay, ये तो verbal तो नहीं होने वाला है, कुछ इसका तो कुछ करना ही पड़ेगा. And fortunately, I gave a lot of time with verbal, and I ended up scoring 98.4% in verbal. So it's been a huge journey for me. If the total mock score is considered, I was scoring somewhere around 50-55% at the start, and eventually the score increased. But my major increase is in verbal. So one thing that I would make sure that I have seen a lot of your videos where you keep saying that if you have a good control over one section, your CAT paper would be in a good way. So this is the strategy which I followed basically. I focused on verbal because I was loving to read articles. I was loving to read solve comprehensions and parajumbles, and it did wonders for me. So even if I'm not able to score good enough in quant, I still ended up with 96%.
Good, very good point यार. See, I believe 5 mocks it will take to understand कि CAT है क्या.
बिल्कुल
ठीक
सर, बिल्कुल.
है. I normally say कि I'll take you 5 mocks to lose virginity when it comes to CAT exam. तो you might, like you said, you might think कि verbal is a weak area, but you will be surprised to know you might be scoring less in DI logic or quant. ऐसा हो सकता है, आराम से, like आपके साथ भी ऐसा हुआ. So it's all individual. So give 5 mocks, then you decide what is your weak and strong. And even within verbal, pura verbal can't be weak. There are some part of verbal which can be weak.
Exactly. Initially, I faced that because I haven't done my engineering from a very good college. So there was a good communication in parts in Hindi or English, what we say that currently now. So when I realized that I was good enough when I was reading comprehensions and solving them, but I was not very confident about parajumbles or parasummary or basically the VA part. So this is where I improved, and which also helped me to improve my comprehension and then eventually the speed. So that
Right.
is how the whole section is improved basically.
Exactly. You have to first वही ना, थोड़ा प्रैक्टिस करोगे तब जाके यू अंडरस्टैंड क्या तुम्हें आता है क्या तुम्हें नहीं आता है.
Short sir, short sir.
सुपर. सो यू लेफ्ट योर जॉब, सो व्हाट वाज गोइंग इन योर माइंड? हाउ यू केप्ट योरसेल्फ मोटिवेटेड? वाज द फैमिली सपोर्टिव? व्हाट यू वर हैविंग फीलिंग द प्रेशर फ्रॉम दैट साइड आल्सो?
To be very honest, fortunately, I was not having many financial constraints on me. So financial thing is something which I was not taking care of. It was my father, and it is my father also as well. Also, when I left my job, it is a huge risk which is involved in CAT because CAT is very uncertain. So I do have a fair share of my seniors who left the job for CAT or MBA or maybe GMAT, and they might not turned out good in the later series of life. So, you know, you always have these kind of stories haunting you when you leave a well-settled job. Okay, this might not happen with me as well. What would I do if in case this is something which happens with me? Where would I go? I would have lost a good job. I would have lost a 1 year gap and everything would go room down there. So these things haunt, you know, these things haunt overall in the journey of CAT or any preparation you take whatsoever. So the whole challenge which I was facing initially was to get over these things. First, the fear of not getting a good percentile. This is the major fear that everyone is having. And when you look at the initial mock score, these things not do justice as well. So if you are eyeing for a 95 or a 98 percentile, and then you see a mock score of 35 percentile, you would be like, okay, to nahi aane wala boss. Galat jagah aa gaya, job galti kar diya chhod ke. So when I started to talk to people who have aced CAT, I used a lot of YouTube videos. One thing which motivated a lot is your motivation videos, which were at 10 p.m. in the morning. So, you know, being from a middle class family, we always aspire ke, okay, ghar hoga, gaadi hoga, badhiya life hoga, ye hoga, wo hoga. But during the job, we don't realize that we can actually get there. So during the preparation, these things help you motivated. Obviously, the studies is something which will keep you motivated if your performance would increase. But what would be your end goal? Everyone wants to do a MBA from a good college because they want a good life. So good life is the target, basically. So these things help you to keep motivated in the journey.
True. So I need to start my morning show again. Morning
motivation show. It helps.
Yaar, maine rok diya na public wo negative ho gaya tha comment ki why you are promoting placements, why you promoting cars, this and that.
Actually, the point is now, CAT 2020 was almost hit by COVID. The exam was also uncertain at that point of time, and we keep listening to news of someone unfortunate demise, or someone is not doing well with life, or someone who has lost a job. So these kind of things help you to boost up, basically, because when you see your sorrow everywhere, something, a good life basically keeps you happy. Okay, I will do good. I might not end up there. So these things help a lot, specifically at that point of time where everywhere is sorrow.
True. Exactly my point, yaar. So, all right. So aapka journey. So anybody want to start now? So we are now right now sitting around mid of June. Mm-hmm. What do you think? Can a person crack the IIM calls if he's starting today?
Definitely. One of my friend is scored 98.xx percentile and she started in the month of October. So it is possible, obviously. It obviously depends upon.
मैं करूँगा ना अगर तो नीचे कमेंट आएंगे fake है ये तो बेचेगा इसको तो बेचना है अरे भाई
It obviously depends upon how much basics you are having a good hold of. Obviously, if someone is having a good aptitude, CAT is something which would be a piece of cake for him or her. So it obviously depends on how much basics you are having strong. But yeah, it is very well possible.
True. All right. So great. So I missed your academic record. Can you please tell us your academic record?
Sure, sir. So I scored 8.4 CGPA in 10 CBSE board. Later on, I scored 88.6% in 12th CBSE Board 2. And I scored 70% in my BTEC, which is from AKT, Abdul Kalam Technical University.
Okay, superb. So it's 8, 9, 8.
887, you can say
887,
that.
887, right.
Yeah, right. Basically, right. Not very good.
Okay, so what advice you would like to give? What few things that you think you could not have, you have not done, but you could have done? ताकि हम लोग उस चीज का ध्यान रखें इफ आई एम प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द एग्जाम सो एनीथिंग यू फील दैट यार ये मुझे करना चाहिए था मैं नहीं किया
वन थिंग इज दैट व्हेन यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर कैट एंड यू हैव रीच्ड अ गुड लेवल ऑफ प्रिपरेशन दैट इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज दैट यू आर केप्ट कंटीन्यूअसली स्कोरिंग 90% और बियॉन्ड इन योर मॉक्स एंड व्हाटएवर टेस्ट सीरीज दैट यू आर गिविंग फॉर यू शुड वेल बी टारगेटिंग हाउ टू गॉज द डिफिकल्टी लेवल ऑफ द पेपर सो इट हैपेंड विद मी इट इज माई एक्सपीरियंस दैट व्हेन आई वॉज डूइंग DILR इन माई सेकेंड स्लॉट टू इट वॉज फॉर द कैट 2020 आई एंडेड अप डूइंग 7 क्वेश्चंस इफ आई रिमेंबर करेक्टली आई रिमेंबर डूइंग 7 क्वेश्चंस आउट ऑफ 24 एंड एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम आई वॉज वेरी डिमोटिवेटेड बिकॉज आई डिड वेल इनफ इन वर्बल आई वॉज फीलिंग दैट ओके आई डिड वेल इनफ इन वर्बल एंड देन आई वॉज हैविंग अ प्रैक्टिस ऑफ डूइंग 11 12 क्वेश्चंस इन माई मॉक्स But when I ended up doing only 7, I was like, okay, ye toh gaya boss, agle saal phir se dena padega. And then I moved towards washroom and spent 4-5 minutes still there. एंड देन आई रिटर्न ऑन, एंड उनके बाद आई वॉज लाइक चलो सात आठ क्वेश्चन कर देते हैं, पेपर तो क्या अगले साल फिर से देना पड़ेगा, फिर देखते हैं. बट आफ्टर द पेपर आई रियलाइज दैट ओके सेवन क्वेश्चन वाज अ गुड इनफ स्कोर, इट इज इट माइट बी गेटिंग मी 92-93% टाइम. सो दिस इज समथिंग विच यू नो हॉन्टेड मी लेटर ऑन, कि इफ आई वुड हैव नॉट लॉस्ट होप आफ्टर द डीएलआर सेक्शन, इफ आई वुड हैव वॉच्ड द डिफिकल्टी लेवल ऑफ द पेपर, I would have obviously scored two, three questions more and my percentage would be maybe 97 or 98.
97.
So, gauging the difficulty of paper is very crucial for every aspirant. And this is something which has hit me, and I would make sure that it might not hit anyone who is preparing for that. So, basically, what my point is that you have to give your best. No matter which section you are not doing good, you have to give your best till the time period is over. Because you never know how much the other people have done.
Same happened to me as well, yaar. After my CAT exam, मैं 12 के रात को I literally cried, कह रहे बकवास गया पेपर, मैंने भी जॉब छोड़ दिया था, so now no way to go, this and that. And when the result came, I came to know that I'm 99.9.
Sir, I was literally, you know, watching YouTube videos and the comparison of the percentile. So there are many institutes who come up with the इतने question पे इतना होगा, and you being one of my great followers for that. I used to follow your videos, kitne question pe itna ban jayega. So I was eyeing that. I was like, okay, I am scoring 92% in DLR as well. Why didn't I went for quants? So gauging the difficulty and maintaining your composure for the whole amount of period, whether it is 2 or 3 years, is something which everyone should target for.
True. Yaar, mera simple advice hai to everyone who is watching this video, ke agar tumhari phat rahi hai, to tere saath wale ki bhi phat rahi hai.
Be confident for your preparation, basically.
Exactly.
You should be confident, yeah.
Exactly. सब साथ में ही, उसका भी कटेगा, तेरा भी कटेगा, सबका कटेगा, तो कट ऑफ ऑटोमेटिकली विल गो लो.
Obviously, it is a percentile based game, right? It is not a marks cut off. So.
True. Exactly. Superb. Great. So, anything you like to add in this journey for the students, coming batch, upcoming batch?
One major thing is that CAT is an exam which is solely based on your aptitude and solely based on how well you can understand things and do it in the prerequisite amount of time, whether it is 2 or 3 hours. So maintaining composure and believing in your preparation is something which is the key to success in CAT. See, I've seen people who are scoring way beyond me than maybe 99 or 100 percentile in mocks and in good series mocks, maybe the famous mocks which are AIM CATs and SIM CAT and everything. And they ended up scoring 90 percentile because their confidence was low on the detail. The paper was not that much tough. See, I've seen a lot of videos that paper was tough and verbal was a nightmare and everything. But for me, verbal was the strong part and hence verbal was very easy for me. So it basically depends on how much you are prepared for that particular section. You can easily target videos ke verbal asaan aane wala hai ya English aane wala hai. Honestly, nobody knows CAT mein kya hone wala. It is just prediction. So agar aap teen section aapke achche se tayyar hain, to CAT is an, it is eventually an exam only. If sir, you have seen aspirants a new series.
True.
Aapne aspirants dekha hai sir, jo bhi series aaya TVF ka. आपने सुना होगा उसके बारे में, तो उसमें एक सेंटेंस है कि ये सब कहने की बातें हैं कि ये सब्जेक्ट टफ है, इसमें नंबर नहीं आने वाले, या वीए पार्ट सॉल्व भी नहीं होगा, या डीएलआर में सेट थ्योरी आ गए तो भूल जाओ, जो पढ़ेगा उसका सॉल्व होगा. दैट वो टॉपिक है. इफ यू वुड हैव अ वर्ड विद 100% आंसर, वो ये नहीं बोलेगा कि मेरे को सेट थ्योरी नहीं आता. सो बेसिकली यू हैव टू बी कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट योर प्रिपरेशन एंड प्रिपेयर एवरीथिंग. यू नेवर नो कैट में क्या है.
वेरी ट्रू. Very true. Ah, see, there are some topics which you can't improve. Matlab, you can't become God in the area.
But at least,
focus on your weak area. Improve your weak. At least make them normal.
Make them normal. You should not be like, "This question I have to leave."
Exactly.
Because if the same question comes and the first 3-4 questions are coming, you skip them. You would be gone. After 10 minutes, gone, it is done.
Then you're gone.
You are gone. True. Recover होने का time नहीं है ना सर. 3 घंटे में recover होने का time होता है. 2 घंटे में तो recovery का time नहीं है. अब अगर आपका एक सेक्शन में 10 मिनट चला गया तो आपने 25% टाइम तो जीरो कर दिया. वही चीज है, तो ये चीज बहुत जरूरी है. इनफैक्ट
सुपर्ब. ग्रेट यार, ग्रेट. सो वी हैव ब्रेकन अ फ्यू मिस ब्रोकन कि यार इंजीनियर्स को 99 के नीचे कॉल नहीं आएगा, दिस एंड दैट. सो वी मूव टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन नाउ. यू हैव गॉट अ फ्यू आईएम कन्वर्ट्स एंड देन ऑन द अदर हैंड यू हैव आईएमपी गाजियाबाद एज वेल.
यस सर.
सो व्हिच इज योर कॉल, व्हाट यू आर थिंकिंग अबाउट, वेयर टू गो?
Sir, I've been a huge dilemma, honestly. The reason is that I belong from NCR region only, which is Moradabad, I told you. And Ghaziabad is around 150 kilometers. Not Samne, but very fast. It is 150 kilometers from me. And I
150?
150 kilometers from my place only.
Okay.
I take Ghaziabad. So basically, I was working in Noida only when I was doing my corporate job. So Noida and Ghaziabad are like 15 or 12 kilometers apart. So the place is very known to me. Also, I have heard a lot about IMT Ghaziabad's marketing and the prominent recruiters there. It's obviously on a huge glory, which the institute has maintained over the last 40 years. On the other hand, I am having the dream of every aspirant, the IIM calls. So, you know, it is a very tough decision. Okay, where should I go? At one point of my brain, I am having killing and I am jana, wo I am ka hoodie pehna hai aur I am jana. Usi ke liye taiyari kar raha tha, wahi jana. On the other hand, I am having ke wahan pe ye aa raha hai, ye aa raha hai, ye aa raha hai. So, you know, it is a huge dilemma. So that is where I am slightly confused ke which is to opt for.
हाँ वही ना यार, ये अगर आई एम शिलोंग होता या आई एम कोई कुड़ होता तो
कोस्ट नहीं देता यार, इट कुड हैव बिकम अ शिफ्ट फॉरवर्ड चॉइस यार.
ये प्रॉब्लम इज दे आर ऑलमोस्ट सेम लेवल ब्रांड्स, बट यार इफ यू, आई वाज जस्ट चेकिंग द आईएफटी का रिपोर्ट यार, वी हैव दिस इज वी हैव 30% बैच फ्रॉम एनआईटीज आईआईटीज एंड एसआरसीसीज. अभी जिसको एनआईटी मिल रहा था बट उसने छोड़ के ही पिक अप सम अदर गुड कॉलेज व्हिच माइट बी इक्वली गुड, ही माइट बी फील द पिंच ना ऑल हिज लाइफ, ही इज नॉट फ्रॉम दैट प्रीमियम ब्रैकेट ब्रांड नेम. आईएमटी गाजियाबाद की वैल्यू इज ओनली इन द पीपल हु आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर एमबीए और दोज़ हु आर एमबीए. आउटसाइड वालों में ज्यादा नहीं है. आईएम का ब्रांड नेम इज वर्ल्ड फेमस.
ऑब्वियसली इट इज इंडियन, किसी भी चीज के आगे इंडियन लग जाएगा तो फेमस हो ही जाएगा.
ट्रू, वेरी ट्रू यार. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपको मैं सिंपल, बिट्स पिलानी द टॉप कॉलेज, नो डाउट अबाउट दिस, आईआईटी बॉम्बे के इफ नॉट बेटर बट उससे कम भी नहीं, उसके बराबर का ब्रांड है. But if you look at from an outsider point of view, IIT Ropad, which is हमारे पंजाब का new IIT,
might
have a bigger brand name abroad, everywhere, when it comes to the MBA as well, कि यार नहीं, तुम IIT से हो. वो brand name is equally good.
Obviously, obviously. And this is where the confusion lies. If it would have been a clear comparison, I won't be having a dilemma. The dilemma exists because these colleges are very near and everyone is having its own pros and cons. So,
exactly.
Fingers crossed, I hope so, I decide better for myself.
Exactly. All the best. Achha, yaar, aise confusion achhi baat hai.
Aray, sir. These are all happy headaches. I had a word with one of my seniors. He told me that these are all happy headaches. You should be happy that you are having these headaches.
True. All the best, yaar. All the best.
Thank you so much, sir.
Hopefully, to see you in the top college in next couple of years.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Bye, sir.